All right. Okay. I think it worked. Restarted it. Still says I don't have any viewers, but I think we'll be okay. Let's just go with that. If you're watching this archive on YouTube, we streamed for a couple minutes and things weren't quite right, so I stopped the stream and restarted it. Harold says he used Instagram once. I have an Instagram. I don't use it that often. There were not many photos between this Halloween and 2016 or 2017's Halloween, I should say. They're pretty close together on my end. All right, I'm gonna retweet my one here and just reply to this and say, had to restart the stream. Good now. Just tweeting out, letting people know. Okay. Well, hopefully everything's gonna be good. I still have some weird stuff on my shoulder here from the lights. I got, as I said, I acquired through Amazon.com. I purchased new umbrellas. I took a photo of one of them and put it on my Twitter, and I'll put it on the Discord later tonight, which should help. But I did have to then replace one of, or I had to move one of my lights, and so now I'm readjusting for that. But I think we'll be okay. I'm going to go and bring up one more thing. I'm sorry. It's our normal Saturday stream. It's not even a weird night. And my settings aren't that much different, but for some reason, everything's weird. And, not the non-dashboard version of Twitch says that I do not have, any viewers, which is really weird. And annoying. That's weird. Hello, board! Hello and welcome to the chat board. It's nice to see that there are people here in the chat watching. I know some of you did say hello, and I appreciate that. It's weird. Lashbrook, this would be a weird thing, for a weird way for you to find out you are a ghost. So, I hope you're not. I don't think y'all are ghosts. I don't think I'm a ghost. I don't think you're a ghost either. I think it's mostly just that Twitch is doing a weird thing. And it's annoying because I like to know how many viewers I have. Lurkers can go full ninja lurkers tonight. Yeah. Well, also because, like, sometimes people, it lists the, you know, users in chat, and sometimes those users aren't watching, they're away. So I don't know if they're actually in chat. Like, I don't know if David and Discuk and Eon 2000 and Electric Skateboard, great, Electrical Skateboard, sorry, I said electric, is your Electrical Skateboard, and Kat Jokowski, Sovicki, and MetaMac, we said hello to already. Nade and Positivity Bot. I don't know if you're in the chat. Maybe you are. Oh, okay. Well, David says, your stream isn't appearing in my Roku Twitch app. Actually, no creative videos are appearing at all. Okay, well, that might... looks like something's going on weird with Twitch, which sucks. That sucks because... I would like to be discovered. I would like for people who aren't following me on Twitter and happen to be looking right now to know that I'm streaming. So that sucks. But all right, well, I'm new. Hi, Pat. Hello. Eno, welcome. I'm happy you're here. We're going to get to building in just a moment. Usually the beginning of the stream, kind of just chat with y'all. Harold, happy you're still here. I just assumed that there is some weird stuff going on with Twitch, and it's not me. Okay, it doesn't say that I'm going live, board says. On PC using Firefox, it does not show you live in the followed channels. That's, annoying. But we'll deal with it. I think it'll be okay. This is the worst four-day weekend for tech. Mr. Bob, you're not wrong. Let's go to the overhead shot. We're still working on our Zaku 2. Now, we finished the body of the Zaku 2. The Zaku 2 body is pretty much complete. There's some weapon holder stuff that we're going to put on. Yeah, Mr. Bob, I'm happy it's working. Certainly. We didn't really have any problems yesterday, but of course, you know. It's not showing you live on iOS either. Yeah, I mean, that sucks. That's probably why I'm not getting a viewer count, because it's not showing me as streaming. That's annoying. Hopefully it'll all count my numbers and stuff. So I'm nowhere near ready for partner, right? We know that based on the size of this channel, not ready for prime time in that respect. But I did hit my one of my goals, which was the amount of days streamed and the amount of hours streamed in a month. Those two Hearthstone streams, those extra streams kind of put me over for that, which is cool. I still have not hit that 75 viewers average, which is the third thing. And of course, that doesn't mean automatic you're going to become a partner out of affiliate if you hit those magical numbers. But that is like a guide. Like, if you can't pull that off, and that makes sense, you know, they want to see that you have an audience and it's consistent. And I get that. I'm not trying to, cheat the system or anything. But partner would be cool. Opens up a lot of avenues. All right, so we got our Zaku 2. We also built our beam bazooka and our three giant bazookas. So we built all those. I'm going to put those aside because they're big. We built all that. Finished our Zaku. And so let's get into our machine guns. We're building two machine guns. So we need A and A. Harold says, nowhere close to 75 concurrents. Yeah, I mean, that takes a lot. That's just not where I'm aware. That's not where, like, I'm at right now. I mean, I'm okay with that. It'll happen. And it just hasn't happened yet. Or it won't happen, and I'll be an affiliate for a really long time. I'm very happy with the affiliate program as it is, because I appreciate that it's not an all or nothing, that it's not you just stream and maybe have a donation page that you kind of ping, or you are a partner, and so I appreciate that. I also appreciate that they just flat out say, they're like, oh, yeah, well, this is the thing, but it doesn't guarantee you're going to become a partner just by hitting these three things. So, I appreciate that. So, Nade, there are a lot of differences. The percentage of payment and the money you receive is a very big one. So, right now, anyone that subscribes to me here, either using their Twitch coin through Twitch Prime, cheers seem to be working. Harold, thank you for the test. I appreciate that. So any money that I get in, through that, through cheers, through bits, that all goes to, what was I saying? Oh, so that all gets split 50-50 between myself and Twitch. The partner program, that number is different. There are certain state badges, like right now every level gets one emote. And then I can unlock more as it goes. Oh, thank you so much for using your Twitch Prime coin, MetaMac, and subscribing. That's awesome. As I said, I do get 50% of that. And it goes to me just buying kits, which I'll, of course, say later. I never did get my Amazon affiliate stuff set up. I got a weird error message. Board just threw the Bear Cave emote in there. I'll throw my emotes in as well. So right now I have the Bear Cave emote, and I have the Lego emote, which is for $10 a month, which is just Iron Souls, who never watches live, just does the $10 and watches the VODs. Hi, Iron Souls. Thank you very much for your continued support. But yeah, there are other smaller things. There's more support. Obviously, partner has perks. Not, well, maybe not honestly. But, like if you go to an event that Twitch is at, they and you could you tell them they'll have, you know, access to their back area. You can hang out. You can set up meet and greets through them. Not all partners, but a lot of them. Sometimes they have like, yeah, they have certain benefits here and there. Of course, being a Twitch partner is a great way to start working with outside groups to do things, because it shows, you know, like people might want to work with you because you're a partner, whereas you're an affiliate, well, they might not. But yeah, I do need to look at that Amazon affiliate stuff. I got an error message when I tried to set it up, so I didn't. Oh, hey, thank you so much. Also using their Twitch Prime is Eno2K. Eno, thank you so much for that. I really appreciate it. Hello and welcome. Happy to have some folks here in the chat. So nice to see that. Okay. We are now at 29 subscribers, which is awesome. I am very happy about that. We're on our way to our next milestone, which is 30 concurrent subscribers, which is rad. 29 is great. It is towards the end of the month, so that's awesome. Hopefully we'll get that. Maybe we'll get that today. Maybe we'll get that on Monday. I am doing a bonus stream on Monday. I mentioned this before. It's my monthly game stream where we play games with the chat. I'll be playing something while like people kind of hang out, and then when there's a lot of people in the chat, we will play like Quiplash and TKO and, you know, games that are good for chat as a thank you to y'all. And that will be on Monday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., which is earlier than I normally do, but unfortunately that's where it had to be. It was either do it then or do it on Tuesday, and I'm not going to compete with premium members watching Giant Bomb's live podcast, so I'm not going to do that. None of the Jackpot 5 games to be large party size. So, I just played on Thanksgiving. We did an 8-person of the rap battle, and that is a great game for a large party. We played Split the Room, and I didn't really like it. I knew I wasn't keen on Split the Room, but rap battle was fun. The rap battle was a lot of fun. People seemed into it. We ended up doing it twice in my crew, which is a pretty good endorsement that people who, you know, wanted to do it again. So that was pretty good. All right. So it goes like that. Okay, so it just goes in like that. So we put that in this. But yeah, Quiplash and Bracketeering can go over 8 players. Yeah. Quiplash 2 is 8. Drawful, which is a separate thing, is a lot more. And I think Bracketeering can go more. But I think Quiplash tops out at 8. It might do 10. I don't remember. But I don't think so. But yeah, as far as games to play with people goes, Split the Room went well, and well, pretty well. I don't really like that game, but it went over all right. And the rap battle, people were really into. And then we just went back and played Quiplash, because that's a game that people know how to play and like. Tried to get a TKO going, but there wasn't enough interest, unfortunately. It's a lot of setup. You know, it's a lot of top ends. So I do understand that. All right, so now we're going to do J15 and J6 on both of these. Just finishing off these machine guns. Nothing too complicated about these guns. Bracketeering does 16, everything else does 8. Oh, okay. That makes sense, Harold. Yes. I remember the bracketeering did a lot of people were allowed to play that. I wish that I had been able to play the business proposal game, because That does not work on stream unless everyone who's playing is in the, you know, is on like a Skype call, or, you know, we're all playing through Discord or something. That's not gonna really work. Harold is now hosting the stream. Thank you very much for hosting, Harold. You just now got my notification. Lastbrook just got a notification. That's great. I'm going to connect these up. I'm going to actually thank you very much for letting me know. Yeah, I'm getting a lot of weird. I got my Streamlabs is how I use my notifications. You see all that, and they send me reports on data, and they were like, so the before I started and stopped the couple minutes I did here, my peak views were zero and my chatters were three, so it did not count any of you as viewers. Oh, now I have 11 viewers. Great. Okay, so there was definitely something weird with Twitch. So now it says that I have 11 viewers, which is great. Patently stupid. Yes, patently stupid. Yeah, I think that patently stupid works with like comedians, and I was with and you know, presentational folks. I was with a bunch of those, but I think they were that kind of done with playing new games. They just wanted to play something they knew how to play, which I understand. I wasn't mad about it, but I did want to check it out, and I felt like a live setting was the only way I was going to be able to. So I was a little bummed. Yes, I'm now my board says your existence has been recognized by Twitch. Yeah, that's good. At least we're up. That works. All right. Well, if people followed me, I'm from, you know, here by Twitter, so and some people know when I stream, so they show up, which is nice. My schedule next week is weird. Monday, 2 p.m. to 4 p.m., as I said, playing games. Okay, so we finished our machine guns, and we can put those aside. Oh no, sorry, we have one more step on our machine gun. I apologize. We're gonna do J8 and 7. Okay, so Monday, doing my normal build stream. Wednesday night, 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern time, my normal time that I stream, but the day early because I won't be available to do on Thursday. On Thursday night, I might have a short test stream go up. I think I'm going to try to do that. So I might have a short test stream on Tuesday or Thursday, I should say, just like seeing if I can get from my Airbnb if it looks good, if I can get a stream working on that. And if I can, then that Saturday night and the normal time of 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern, I will stream out of my Airbnb. But I'm going to test it on Thursday. So Thursday won't be a full, you know, regular thing. It'll just be kind of a let's see what's up, let's try this out stream. And I'll probably like hang out and chat a little bit. But it won't be a full stream on Thursday. So I'm doing it on Wednesday instead because I don't like taking time off. And Wednesday will also be the last full stream of November. So it is my stream where I give away a model kit. This will be the Master Grade Gundam Epeon from Gundam Wing. It's a very awesome kit. I really enjoyed building it, and I'm happy to send it out to someone cool. And a subscriber will win that. So it's nice that we have so many subscribers that I'll be able to send something to one of them. And that is a kit that we built on stream. I am now triple checking that because I believe that's the Epion I'm sending out. And now I'm going to just make sure. Yes, the Gundam Epion from Wing Gundam. Ooh. December is two. In December, I'm sending out two Dragon Ball kits. Because that's fun to send. But yeah. Hello, everybody that's joined in the chat. on the stream, Twitch was being weird and didn't say that I went live when I did go live, which is strange. So, all right, we finished our guns here. Gotta put these up. See those? Put those aside. We still have some strum thoughts and an axe to build. So let's build those things. Okay. Gotta. The axe requires actually no building. They made the axes for us, which is pretty cool. Just an axe. I just have two axes. That's fun. And then, yeah. One cool thing is we'll take out J13. There it is. All right, so when I put this on, one of these axes, I can clip it to the back of our Zaku. There's a little peg there. And then it can keep one of its axes on its back for easy grabbing, which is pretty cool. I'll show that off with there. Smash Mouth, hello, Johnny. Welcome to the chat. Always a pleasure to have you here. Been building for about, half hour. Of course, we started a little late, and then things were weird where Twitch didn't want anyone to know that I was streaming. I was just going to assume it was just me, that it wasn't anyone else, and they were just being weird about me. They were trying to keep me down, I assume. I don't know what happened. It's fine. Technology. As Mr. Bob said earlier, it's a miracle anything works this weekend, because this is a holiday where just websites stop working. Websites stop working. Lots of issues if you're trying to log into a network for gaming because of all of the sudden new, this and around Christmas time is when suddenly there are just new people on new systems being sold and new people playing games, and suddenly you can't do a thing. Because too many people are doing it. Alright, so let's find S. It's Q1. It's Q2. There's S2 and S1 and S2. Because we are building this kind of like rocket poles. I don't have a good name for these things. They're called strum fausts. We'll build them here. They're like javelins with missiles on the end. That sounds about right. You can make three of them. And you can just put them in his hand if he wants, which is pretty funny. All right, that's one. And it's two. So, obviously, we still have to do the big backpack here. We still have some more building to do. But I do have our next kit, the Grimgaard from Iron-Blooded Orphans, is going to be a future kit that we work on here on the stream. That's the next kit. That was bought anonymously on my off my Amazon wish list. And I have another thing coming. I was given notification by somebody who would like to remain anonymous. I know who it is, but letting me know that apparently there was a delay on the Lego Ninjago Volcanic Lair. But that is coming, and that will be something we do in the future. But also, which was really nice, the person that bought it for me said, put it in your poll. Don't just do it. Like, if your patrons who vote want to do something else, we'll do that. Which was very nice of them to say. So that is a thing that is going to be on the in the future. We'll do that. Which is great, because I would really like, honestly, I really want that Wing Gundam 160 no grade. I really want to fucking build that thing. I've been waiting. But then wonderful folks like Ian, who bought this, and the anonymous people that bought other things, keep buying me kits, and then I won't got to build those next, because that's my rule. But I'm like, when do I get to build the thing I bought with money that came from Twitch? I want to build a big old Wing Gundam. It's like a high grade, but in 160 scale. I got to build that thing. All right, it's time to start working on our backpack. Put this over here, hang out with all of his many, many weapons. When I'm done with this kit, I think I'm going to take a photo of Zaku, and then I'm going to take a photo of all the weapons so that I don't have to try to squeeze it all in together. It's a lot. All right, here's N. Okay. We're doing it. Got to do two of these. And four. So at the very end of the stream last night, because last night I streamed because I took Thanksgiving off. So I streamed last night, and I was talking last night at the end. Finally, it got brought up about it was time to talk about Goku. And, you know, we didn't really get to talk too much about it because it was the end of the stream. And talk about how Super Saiyan Blue Goku was at the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. And I'm still getting choked up about that. It's just fucking awesome. It's just so great that that happened. Like, as I've said, I'm a broken record about this. I have been a fan of Dragon Ball for 23 years. Since it debuted, the first arc was dubbed and released. I have been a fan of that show. Because that seemed awesome, and I wanted more and more, and I started watching it subtitled, and I watched, you know, while Dragon Ball Z was in English on TV, I was watching that. I remember it came on Sundays, and I had to, the very first Dragon Ball Z arc, when it came out, it was on Sundays for me, and I had to record them. Because they were while I was supposed to go to church. Because I was still going to church at that time. So I had to tape them on the VCR. The VCR I had in my bedroom. So that I could watch them when I got home from church. And they started doing a thing locally where I was. Where they would show the previous week's episode. Before the new one. Because they were trying to build an audience. I watched a lot of it. I watched Dragon Ball Z, and I went back and watched fan subs of Dragon Ball and caught up on Dragon Ball Z and watched the arc that they skipped, the filler arc that they skipped in the dub, and, you know, like, got a new appreciation, a new understanding of both series and have loved it so much over the years. And, you know, tolerated GT, found the things to like about GT, because there were things to like. And then loved Super. Can't believe, like, no spoilers about Super. No spoilers here. There's a moment towards the last episode that is an incredible payoff. It plays people's character games, and it's so fucking good. But also, I will say this, because it's, like, storyline stuff, whatever, it happens in there. There's more great Saiyan Man, and that's one of my favorite Dragon Ball Z arcs. Yes. Yeah. Lash Brooks' spoiler Super is great. There's just a... I'll say this. I'm not going to say what it is. Some folks know. Irabina, hello. Welcome to the chat. There's a Vegeta thing. There's a look Vegeta gives in the last episode of Super that is encapsulates his feelings about Goku and Earth and his place in the universe. And it's this beautiful, wonderful payoff that I was so thrilled with. It's just like, I don't know. There's something really special about Dragon Ball Super. So, yeah, this is a thing that I've loved for a very long time. I hold in incredibly high regard. And to have it, like, yes. There was a period where if you watch Cartoon Network, You knew about Dragon Ball. You knew what was up. You knew that it was a thing, and it was, people found it special. And, you know, you could buy the figures at Kmart and Toys R Us, and you could go and watch, or you could go and buy the games, and you could go into, Hot Topic and buy polyester shirts that are supposed to be silk material, with Goku on it, like a full body Goku, you know, like you could, you know, it was out there, it was big, but 2018 felt like a really big year for it. I know I mentioned going to San Diego Comic-Con and having the hotel I was staying in be decorated for Dragon Ball Z, but also, like, there was a mercenary Tao cutout. Like, they were throwing me a bone, and they were giving a shout-out to fans of Dragon Ball. Like, that's unbelievable. It felt so, I don't know, good. Good is a terrible descriptor. Good is a terrible adjective to use. But that's how it felt. I don't know. It's nice to be recognized as a fan, you know? Okay, so Johnny says, I didn't see any of the stuff they added in the anime of GBZ until much later. I don't think it holds up the quality of the material that was directly adapted from the manga. Yes, Super's pretty great. And Boris says, I was really bad about watching Dragon Ball. Now it's like One Piece, so many episodes that I'll never have time to watch. Yeah, so I've read the manga. I think that Dragon Ball, in some ways, is certainly inferior to the manga itself. I think the humor doesn't hit as hard, but I do think that it's a fun adventure. And I understand where you're coming from, bored with it, there being so much of it. I mean, I watched it when I was a young person. I had time to watch, and also I just decided that was the thing I was going to be into and not other things, and didn't watch TV for a while. I was like, well, this is the part of my life where I don't really watch much television. I would just try to catch up on buying VHS tapes of fan subs of Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z. And this is what I'm into now. This is what's up. And sometimes if it's a big series, that becomes your job. And then Johnny says, I don't entirely think it's as good as DBZ as best, but it's a lot better than any of the other DBZ stuff released between DBZ and Super. Yes, I mean, so, Vegeta growing a mustache. Very good. Most of the other stuff in Dragon Ball GT, not so good. I will say, Goten growing up to be not that strong is pretty great, because he's basically as a teenager in GT, he's as strong as he was when he was a kid being raised by his mom. So Chi-Chi got him to a certain point, and he just, like, never got better than that, because Goku, you know, left. Easiest way to say that. Goku abandoned him. So he never got as good as his potential, certainly. Yeah, he never got better than he was as a kid. Which is, you know, it's actually interesting. I don't know. There's a couple things about that. Sector says, I continue reading. Also, hello, Sector. Welcome. I continue reading the manga. If I have some free time, I catch up an episode here and there. I mean, there's some stuff that's great that you're just not going to get by reading, that I think is fun to watch live. And obviously reading, you know, if you got a big collection, it goes fast. You can just get through it. Okay, so I need I and E. E and I. Many a little tiny little eyes here. All right, so we're going to do E8. I don't have any of those. Go to the next one. Also, I did like the concept in Dragon Ball GT that eventually the Dragon Balls like got corrupted from overuse. That's kind of an interesting idea. Goku like being an adult with the body of a child is weird. It's not great. It's pretty weird. Especially because he's always childlike, but you kind of forget that he's adult. Although I did like that, Akira Toriyama like had something to do with it, but it wasn't his baby. Akira Toriyama just being like, okay, oh yeah, you can make people young. And so when they did Super, they just made Pilaf a young kid. And Mai and whatever the name of the animal friend is. I can't remember his name. It's not Chew. Zorbs, hello. Hello and welcome. I'm, working on our we're working on our big backpack for Zaku 2. This thing has a big old giant backpack we gotta build, so we're gonna get to that. What are your expectations for Dragon Ball Super Broly? Well, Johnny, I have when it comes to Dragon Ball and Dragon Ball Z movies, I don't expect it to be great. I've heard good things about this one, so I do want to say that I have heard good things, but I think it's easier to just be like, well, maybe it'll be fun. Shu. It is Shu? Okay. I thought that's what it was, but I for some reason I couldn't remember what the little guy's name is. They don't really call him by his name much eventually. Hey everybody, that we got some new folks joining us in the chat and watching the stream. Viewers, hello and welcome. We are working on the Zaku 2. We finished the body, we worked on the weapons. We're now working on the giant backpack this thing has. So we're building components for that right now. Should go well. But yeah, the Japan premiere, the world premiere of it, happened this week, and there's footage of the voice actors coming out and being all cool and being, in some instances, very, very old. 'Cause that's, they are. But it was still really fun to see them. And as many of y'all know, Japan feels differently about their voice actors than we do, I think it's pretty obvious that that's true. I mean, I'm gonna go ahead and assume that very successful Japanese voice actors don't, have to crowdfund their own documentaries about themselves to be like, hey, no one else will make this, so we're going to crowdfund our documentary about how, some of the greats that are also us. I feel like that doesn't happen in Japan. Maybe it does. Johnny says that apparently Toriyama wrote the screenplay. Well, that is promising. That's pretty cool. Didn't know that. Of course, also he's been quoted as saying the reason why lunch or launch isn't in the show, isn't in Dragon Ball Super is because he forgot that character existed. Totally forgot he had made that character, which is why she is not in the show. Sector says, I have fond memories of most of DBZ movies, at least the first couple. Might need to watch some of them. Yeah, I mean, there was a. Well, there's one with the androids that's kind of interesting. That's all right. It's just that they're not canon. I mean, like, kind of. They're kind. I don't know. Garlic Jr. I don't know how to figure out how that actually works with Garlic Jr. But there's like, it's fine. They're all fine. I think like the Cooler movie. I remember liking the Cooler movie. I thought that was kind of cool. No pun intended on that. That was literally me just not saying words like I should. And then when I said that movie was cool, I don't know, it was like another version of Frieza. So, I didn't mind that. None of them are canon anymore, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I don't think they are. But I thought that maybe the Garlic Jr. was because Garlic Jr. shows up in the show, so maybe, I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. Occasionally, I don't know what I'm talking about. Not all the time. Don't get it twisted. Sometimes I know what I'm talking about. I always thought Brawly was a real bad villain, but this is apparently be a completely redesigned version, so maybe better. Yeah, I mean, Brawly as a concept, the legendary Super Saiyan. I think now that we've had other universe Super Saiyans go legendary, and we had some context for it, I think it should theoretically make Brawly more interesting because of what else has happened in let me get a find R whatever what's happened in Super. So I think, I'm saying I think that what happened in Super will make it more interesting. I don't know for sure. All right, great. So put one of these aside. We put that there. But yeah, maybe it'd be cool. I don't know. I didn't think Frieza coming back was gonna be cool, and I was proven wrong. It was pretty cool that Frieza came back. All right, that's done. All right, moving along here on this on these weird weapons we gotta build. I'm excited to build the Grimgarde next. I mean, I'm still having fun with this kit, obviously, but the Grimgarde, one of the things that's cool about it is that all right, so I need Q1. Is that it is a non-graded, so it's a 1/100. That's basically a high grade, and but it only has two stickers, and you don't even really need to use them. You can avoid the stickers if you don't want to use the stickers, because you can just do what do you call it? You can it's just the eyeball thing, basically, is stickers. So that's awesome, because usually high grades are full of stickers. Also, it's a sleek, cool design, and because it's an iron-blooded orphans kit, the non-graded, which eventually got named full mechanics, you basically build the skeleton and the armor around it, and that's very cool. Lastbrick says, now bring back Cell. Now please let Cell stay dead. Someone has to stay dead. I mean, Frieza, like, that was a that felt like kind of a big deal. Because I was joking with somebody that had watched Dragon Ball Z and hadn't really paid much attention to anything from Dragon Ball Dragon Ball, the original. And so it was funny to be like, that was a villain, that was a villain, that was a villain. Basically, Krillin has some competitiveness with Goku, but legitimately, the only fighters who were never like out and out villains in the show are Goku, Master Roshi, and Krillin. And then, of course, the competitiveness in fighting in the tournaments and all that. But I mean, like, Krillin didn't want to rob, or at the very least, like, rob or murder Goku. And that's rare. Everybody else, at some point or another, tried to kill Goku. And so it's fun to think about that. It's like, oh yeah, like, everybody was a villain by the end of it. It's like one of the ultimate expressions of that trope. It starts there, where it's just like, start as a villain, new villains that are more and more evil get in, you gotta be good. Like, remember, Piccolo was still pretty good even before he merged back with Kami. It's like King Piccolo's offspring was still like an all right dude, but there, you know, training methods leave a little bit to desire. Not particularly great with kids, still better than Goku, but not, you know, great with kids. But it is funny to think about that. Like, everyone that Goku now fights with at one time was like very evil and going for the jugular. And then only like Raditz and, you know, Raditz was felt like the first big bad, and then Cell are like the only real villains in the you know, villains that never came back in any way, shape, or form. All right, and Q2, I need Q2. Right, pop this out. I don't know. I'm looking forward to the Brawley movie. I don't know when I'll see it, but I am looking forward to it. I always like to see that stuff. All right, we're gonna finish this piece up here. Then I'll take a pause for the cause. Talk about the ways that y'all can benefit to support me here on the stream. Obviously, a lot of you already are, which is fantastic, and I genuinely very much appreciate it. But right now, oh, so somebody, I don't know who, but somebody renewed their subscription, and we have officially hit 30 subscribers. I now, at this very moment, have 30 subscribers, and that's awesome. I'm gonna go to Streamlabs and see who renewed, if that'll tell me. See here. But that's awesome. Thank you all so much. That fucking rules. It's very, very cool. And I don't know. I don't know who renewed because they didn't make it. They didn't hit the button to let me know. Board says cool, and Board is right. And then Johnny says there's also a weird thing where like Piccolo is kind of a kid himself. He's an adult body and has all his dad's memories. He's only been his own person for like 3 years. Yeah, he is like kind of young when all that happens. He doesn't have much life experience. He just has memories because he's like an offspring but also a clone, and it's, I don't know, it's complicated. All right. Yeah, so first and foremost, we'll take the break here as I do my ad reads. Thank you so much. Everybody who's being a subscriber, either you're paying with money or you're using your Twitch Prime token, thank you so much for that. It means a lot to me. It means I keep being able to buy kits and building kits. I now have a good stock through the rest of the year. I'm very excited about that. If you're not a subscriber, consider it. You can use your Twitch coin if you have Twitch Prime because you have Amazon Prime and you link to your accounts, or you can use money if you want to do that. If you're following me, that's awesome. Please turn notifications on. They normally work. They didn't work tonight. I also have a Patreon. $1, you get a video once a month where I do a Q&A that's just for patrons. $5, you get videos early. As soon as it's done, I'll start uploading it and send it out there. Everybody else gets stuff early. $10, you get to vote on kits I build next. We're doing the Grimgarde next, but after that, I will put a poll up for what I do after the Grimgarde, and I will do that probably during the week because that high grade kit's not going to take too long. I'll finish it by the end of next week or the following week, I should say. And then I've got an Amazon wish list. This was bought off my Amazon wish list by Irabina. Ian bought this kit off my Amazon wish list. The Grimgarde was also bought. There's a Lego set that was bought. A lot of my kits get bought off that. I constantly update it. I also put a little tech in there. There are still some Black Friday deals, and so I added, I'm gonna look at it real quick. It's no longer for sale. On sale, but it is for sale, I should say. I put the Elgato Stream Deck up there because I thought that, like, that's not something that I need, but would be cool. And of course, like I said, it went back in price. What didn't go back up in price yet is a is the an awesome webcam that has a light on it that would be great. It's usually $100. Right now, it's $70. That's like, it would be great to upgrade these cams. They're good, but I would really like if this cam that's facing me had its own light on there. It'd actually make things a lot easier for me. But also, hey, there's also model kits and stuff like that. That's fun. You could just buy that, and I'll build it on stream. And make sure you fill out the note so I know that I'm doing it. I know who you are when I build your kit. And then also, I've got my coffee there. We're gonna build for another hour, but I did want to take a time there. And then I've got my Discord. I should mention my Discord. My coffee is just a tip jar. It's just being like, hey, buy me a couple coffees. All the money I make goes into buying kits, and then so I can build those kits or equipment. My new, as I said, I have the photo of my new lights. That comes directly from y'all. Those are $15 for these new umbrellas for the lights, and that's because of your generosity, which I do genuinely appreciate. I sometimes sound disgenuous because it's, a little bit of a broken record sometimes, but it's only because you folks support me that I get to keep doing this thing that I really love doing. So thank you very much. And I'm gonna drink a sip of water and then we're gonna get back into it. Actually, I'll take a sip of water in a second. I am gonna tweet out that we hit 30 subscribers. So give me a second here. Till 11 p.m. Eastern. All right, let me just write out this message here. And again, thank you all so much for being so supportive. I'm gonna cough. I did a lot of talking this week. I'm sure I'll do even more next week, obviously, because of PAX Unplugged. I leave for PAX for Philly on Thursday. And that'll be fun. I am looking to do some extensions here for streaming. Maybe something that like says how many viewers there are on the screen, how many subscribers. Maybe something that like is like an interface for my wish list or something like that. I've been looking at a couple extensions that I could play around with, because I thought that might be cool to do. But I don't know. It's nice to have options for that stuff, so we'll see. But I do want to start looking at other ways to kind of change up the presentation. I mean, honestly, the overhead shot, me being here, green screen, all that's good. I mentioned it briefly yesterday. I am trying. I did try out XSplit. And using their, I'm still using OBS, but using XSplit's new VCam, which it basically tries to remove the background. It does other things, but it adds its own background. Basically, it's like doing green screen and software. Now, they want the GTX 10 series. I have a GTX 970, so I'm a little behind. I'm not up to snuff on that. Well, it's not terrible, really. So I'm not up to snuff there, but the major thing I found was it was my background. Part of my background is black and part of it's white, and I don't think the software liked that. It also didn't like that yesterday I was wearing this, and I'm wearing it today. Oh, I did not change my shirt since yesterday. Hey, y'all, did not change the shirt. I did not leave the house today. So I did not change my shirt. And I'm fucking psyched about that because I got a busy week ahead of me. But that's besides the point. Did not like the plain black shirt in front of a black screen. So there was a lot of, like, garbage information there. So I am going to test it again, probably not until December. I'll probably go back to doing more tests on it then. The idea of not needing a green screen sounds fantastic. Being able to, you know, just stream whenever and not have to do a lot of setup. You know, if all I had to do was set my lights up and turn my webcams on, you know, set the table up, like, and I can remove the whole green screen step, that sounds awesome. So I am very much interested in that, and we'll see if anything comes of it, but I don't know, you know. I can't say for sure that that's going to be a thing that, like, you know, it's definitely going to work or anything. So why is it this? What happened here? Oh, okay. So I put this part on wrong, which happens. Gonna take this apart. Every now and again, I'll screw up. I had really messed up a thing, like, really early on in the build, and it didn't affect anything until I went to put it together, but it happens. So we'll repair this here. Not repair, just redo a piece. Gonna pop this off. Using our sponger, as always, a lot better than trying to do it with our snipper clip. That reminds me, I still have a sponger and snipper clips that I brought over for Austin to use on the Waypoint charity stream, and he was not done with his Gundam, so I left that there for him, and I'm going to need to get that back at some point. Great, okay, so I had screwed that up. Now I have undone my screw up. I can reattach this piece here. That's good. Okay. Oh, all right. So, you know, of course we talked about Dragon Ball, but we got to talk about anime that's come up. I mentioned it yesterday. The new weird anime I'm watching, I didn't watch it. It came out at the beginning of the season and I did not keep up with it. And then I watched all of it because I didn't know that even including the ending credit song, there's no opening credit song, it's only 3 minutes long. Jingai-san no Yome. I mentioned it yesterday. I'm mentioning it again. Jingai-san no Yome is fucking weird. The description I gave, which I still think is apt, is demons and monsters and yokai are real. And they want husbands. No, I'm sorry. They want to get married. But in the relationship, they're the husband. But they want to marry high school boys who take on, like, who are the wives. And it's very light and cute and short. And I don't know. It's fucking weird as hell. It's super weird. All right. And Q1 and Q2. But I'm really enjoying it. I don't know. I am enjoying it. It is fucking weird, but I am having a great time with it. So I do recommend that. Got an email here. Let me see what that is. Another show. Let's talk about Ms. Vampire Who Lives in My Neighborhood. Ms. Vampire Who Lives in My Neighborhood is... this episode, this week's episode, was cute as hell, as always. Such a great show. Really do enjoy that. Just positive and nice. It was summer vacation. It was the four of them hanging out, the two vampires, the two non-vampires, just being friends and seeing what's up. No spoilers, as always, but there was a moment that I'll reference that I thought was just so cute that I have to bring it up. Oh, we got a new follower here. Santini35, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciate it. As always, thanks for folks. Make sure you turn your notifications on so you know when I'm going live, either through email or through just notification in the app or in the, you know, on there. That is helpful for y'all and helpful for me. They're having a sleepover. This show, if you're new to this and you don't know about Ms. Vampire Who Lives in My Neighborhood, there is a vampire, Sophie Twilight. She's lovely and been alive for 350 years. She meets Akari, who is obsessed with dolls. She loves dolls, and she hears word that a living doll is moved to the neighborhood. Turns out that's Sophie the vampire. They become friends. There's another vampire, and then Akari's childhood friend, who's clearly in love with her, and she's clearly in love with Sophie, and Sophie's friend Ellie, who's also a vampire, is clearly in love with Sophie, and it's a whole lot of stuff that's happening, and it's very gay without talking about being gay, which, you know, good and bad that way, but it's really just a solid, great show. And there's a gag where they're all like, hey, get comfortable for the sleepover. Sleep wherever you want. And Sophie tries a couple different options. And then turns out, well, she's most comfortable between the bed and the wall, because it's tight and confined like a coffin. And it was just a funny visual thing. There's a lot of like misconceptions about vampires they talk about and dealing with it. They go to Akihabara in this episode at night because the sun goes down early, so they're able to spend more time out in the world. And it's just, it's a very good show, and I really like it. I love a good slice of life. This is a slice of life that also has, you know, some weirdness to it, obviously, because of the subject matter, and I'm into it. I think it's just, yeah, it's just a solid show. And then, so there's a preview coming out for a show that's coming out in January. So it's good to know that there's going to be another slice of life that's made for me. And that's called Endro! And it is a slice of life about four girls. And it is a fantasy show. And so I guess they're like a party that goes on like quests. And I don't know anything about it. Except all four girls sing the opening song and then one of the girls sings the closing song, and that's all I know. And I think hijinks ensue from them being trying to make it work. And if that seems good, I don't know. I like a good fantasy show. I also like the idea of a fantasy show that isn't the usual kind of like very powerful dude and all the women that love him and support him. It's kind of nice to be like, oh no, here's a fantasy show that's gonna be different. Speaking of which, I mentioned it yesterday. If you haven't been watching That Time I Got Reincarnated as a Slime, man, Monday's episode was necessary for the show to progress, but I kind of knew it was coming, but it was still not really emotionally prepared for it. It was a sad moment in the show. Smash Mouth, that's Johnny, says, so I watched the first episode of Gridman. I enjoyed the episode up until where it became about the fighting. Then I got bored. I understand, Johnny. That show is about the fighting. It is a throwback to a bygone era of fighting shows. I am pretty into it. I don't really talk about it here because I'm way behind on it, but yeah, it is kind of like an old like a throwback. I mean, it's just Ultraman kind of, But there's some modern takes on it. For the most part, I do really enjoy it. But I can understand how you can get bored with the fighting part. I mean, I got bored out with Radiant. Radiant should be right up my alley. I should be totally invested, interested in Radiant. And I just not, like, I kind of want to wait for a bunch of episodes to happen and then skip to that. And, did I talk about Black Clover? There's nothing really to talk about with Black Clover. I still like Black Clover. I understand why people don't. I still think it's great. Noelle is kind of coming to her own, which I think is cool. And, Lanessa, who is a character I don't give a shit about, they've worked hard to make me give somewhat of a shit about her. So, that's nice. I still don't give a shit about Lightning Dude, and I don't think I'm ever gonna give a shit about that guy. The guy that just wants to fight people. I'm like, meh, I don't like that dude. I don't think I ever will. And, of course, I hate, the dude, the mirror guy. He's the, Mineta of the group. Who's really gross, because you gotta have somebody gross there, I guess. I just saw 6 and 7 of Gridman, and I'm interested to see where it goes from there. Oh, cool, yeah, I'm behind on it, but, Johnny says, so there's a third season of a certain magical index happening right now, apparently. Yes, there is. If you like Accelerator is doing a bunch of shit in it. I don't know about that show much of anything. I do know that there's a certain magical index and a certain magical railgun. And they are happening at the same time, and some happen in between episodes of the other ones, but they didn't, and there's an order you can watch if you want to watch it in order. And I don't fucking know. Johnny says, I really, really like a certain certain scientific railgun. That's right, not magical railgun. And you watch Index because the crossover between them. I like Index as a character. I think she's fun. Something very fun about that character. That's good. But yeah. Also, hey. You wish it was more like a Marvel universe rather than you have to watch all of them. They're basically the same show with the same cast, but different people are the heroes in the show, which just seems to be what's going on with that show. I don't know. I like it, but I don't know what's going on with it. I haven't watched all of it. It's not as confusing to me as trying to figure out what the fuck, like, can I watch any Fate series, or do I have to watch all of them in order? In a particular order, and then skip a couple. What? I don't fucking know. Oh, that show, like, whatever. Johnny says, but there being a third season of Index might mean there's a third season of Railgun. I assume that's the case. I assume you don't do one without the other, because they are so intertwined. But I don't know. Maybe. There's a lot of stuff I'm just not watching out there, because I'm also not watching Sword Art Online, the new season of that, mainly because, look, it's a choice. Look, they made a choice they had to make at a certain point, and I can understand it. I don't like it, but I can understand it. There are too many fucking characters in that show. There's too many good guys in the show. And so they were just like, only Kirito. Only Kirito. Again, only Kirito. And we'll introduce some new characters. And then if you're lucky, we'll do an OVA where all of the characters hang out with all the other ones. And I'm just like, I don't care. Johnny says, I'm going to give you my advice. Don't watch Fate. It's such an interconnected mess, and a lot of it's pretty bad. Okay. I kind of want to know, because I know a thing. I know a big thing that, like, was a revelation. Like, I know a plot point. I know that one character is another character. One character is another character in the future. So one character becomes the other character, and they're seeing each other, and they're the same person, but they look different, clearly, and they're different people, but they're like a possibility of someone. I don't know. I know that. I know that there's a thing, and it's like a big fucking thing. So I know that happens. And that intrigued me. I thought that was kind of cool. But yeah, I mean, I don't have time to get invested in that. I got enough stuff to watch. There's going to be a new Hearthstone expansion. I got to play that. Got to play Hearthstone. Like, Fate has a lot of interesting concepts, kind of doesn't land most of it or any of them. Okay, that's good to know. And then, oh, we haven't done much with D's here. Our D, yeah, well, we literally have not pulled a single piece off of D, so that's actually surprising. Now that I look at it, like, we are nowhere near done here. We're not getting to Grimgaird today. We might not get to Grimgaird on Wednesday. There's so much left to build. I thought we were wrapping this up today, but I was wrong. I might instead do a poll about the Grimgaird or doing the Volcanic Lair, because I don't think I'm going to finish this up today, next 15 minutes or so. Do not think so. So much left of this backpack to build. Oh, yeah, we got pages left. Okay. Well, I was wrong. Not complaining. I was just letting you know that I was definitely wrong about how much left we had of this. All right, so let's go like this. That. Just so there are already over 80 episodes of Boruto, and that fact makes me a bit dizzy. Yeah, I am. I was watching it when it started, because I was like, oh, I kind of want to see what this is. I want to see the kids. I want to see, you know, the offspring. I want to see the surprises. Like, oh, that girl that we don't see that much of in Naruto Shippuden, marries Choji. That's cool. They have a kid. That's neat. Or what's Sai's kid like? That's kind of fun. What did Ochama, what the hell? What's going on with this one kid who's clearly a snake evil? What's up? I don't think there are enough kids in that show that aren't the direct descendants, the direct children of all the characters we knew. And I don't think any of those new kids get the time of day. Like, the student council president's kind of interesting, like, but, like, not really. So maybe they've dealt in more, like, the smart kid that gets in, and then, yeah, there's a couple other kids that are there. But I think, honestly, people are just going to be focused on that. I will say it was cool to see Hinata's sister, whose name I can't remember, be kind of grown up and, like, being Boruto's aunt. And like, I think that's fun. Like, being the overprotective aunt. I think that's, like, a cool element to it. But, yeah. I'm way behind on that. So, I'm not expecting that I'm going to be, like, getting caught up with I don't expect to be getting caught up with Boruto anytime soon. There's so much anime out there, y'all. It's a lot. And then there's also this thing where sometimes your friends don't talk about a show, and you're like, well, if nobody I know talks about this, I know people are watching it, but if nobody I know talks about it, like, maybe I don't want to watch it. I dropped out of Naruto around 50 episodes, Mark. There's no way I'm even gonna attempt Naruto. I understand that, Johnny. So I for years let One Piece and Naruto slip away from me. And then I went back, and I caught up on both of them. And that's a lot to catch up on. I caught up on both those shows. I've now fall behind on One Piece because usually I like to just do like a weekend of One Piece. So I am way behind on that show. I just heard some cool stuff about some things that I've missed, so I'm interested in, checking that out. But you said I should take this time and catch up on Thunderbolt Fantasy. Hell yeah. Thunderbolt Fantasy is great. I will say that I am very behind on JoJo because I'm not really liking it. I don't know if I like it. I might not like it. I don't know. Some of the stands are cool, but I don't. I it just really hasn't connected with me, which is a shame because I really like. Because this is gonna be one of the top ones. Here's that goes on top. I'm just gonna put that there. I really liked the last JoJo show, so, but that might be because of all of the, JoJo's, and this show is like no characters that I have any connection to, so I'm like, why do I care about any of these dudes? And the answer is, I don't care about any of those dudes. So yeah, not really feeling it. Fairy Tale, I've been watching here and there, just kind of like whenever. That is a show that I generally like to binge through because I wasn't watching it when it was coming out, so it's kind of fun to be like to get caught up on it. So I'll probably get caught up on that. And I said this already, but I stopped watching as Ms. Beelzebub likes because some of the characters in that show. Some of the supporting characters in the show are creepy as hell, and I'm not into it. Oh, did I say? I don't know if I said it on stream. They announced there's going to be a TV special in December for Cells at Work, one of my favorite shows of the year, is going to have a TV special. I'm hoping that Crunchyroll picks it up. If not, I will find it a fan sub of it. That show is very popular. Somebody's going to be fucking have a fan sub of it up. I'm excited. Coughing. I'm very excited for more. Sorry. Very excited for more of that. That's awesome. Really love Cells at Work, and I'm excited that there is going to be more of the show. That rules. More. So we got these bottom ones we got to put on here. Last Brick says the secret to catching up on something like Naruto is just read the manga. Yeah, I thought for a second you were gonna say the secret to catching up on something like Naruto is don't, which is also the way to catch up on a show, is to just not watch it. That's how I'm catching up on Sword Art Online, just not watching it. So. Well, another day of not watching that show. I'm excited for the next Hearthstone expansion. A couple cards seem cool. Not many that I'm super excited about for decks that I like to play, but there might be something out there. Mostly I'm just like, kind of dreading the next expansion, which comes out in April, probably. They haven't said, but usually it's April. Because when that comes out, like a lot of stuff from this year will go to wild and out of the standard, and that'll be a bummer because a lot of it is card stuff that I really like, cards I really like. All the Death Knight stuff and the quest stuff is stuff that I'm really into, so that'll be a bummer. But yeah. If there's anything you want to chat about, let me know. Usually this last half hour, I do like to turn it over to y'all. If there's something you want to talk about, we can talk about that stuff while I slowly go through all of this. I can't believe I have so much left to build on this backpack. I can't believe I thought I was gonna get done with this today. Nope. But yeah, if there's anything y'all want to chat about, feel free to pop in on it. Once again, Monday at 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern time, I will be playing some games. We will do some Jackbox games later. I'll start with, I don't know, I legitimately don't know what I'm going to start with on Monday at the beginning of the stream. I have not made a decision about what I'm going to do for it. Yeah, I just don't know yet. My assumption is I might just do, I started a new save not too long ago of House Slipper, and I might just do some cleaning in House Slipper because I really enjoy that game, and I might just do that while we wait for the chat to fill up because sometimes it takes a little while for some of y'all to populate the chat on an afternoon. And then we'll play like Quiplash and see where we go from there. We'll start with Quiplash and just play some games. Always a good time, so if you can join me on Monday, that's 2 p.m. till 4 p.m. Eastern time, an afternoon stream. That's my monthly bonus game stream. And then on Wednesday night from 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern, it is my normal build stream. I'm doing it on Wednesday instead of Thursday because I will be traveling on Thursday. So Wednesday night we stream to see what's up. And then on Thursday, I will do probably a test stream for my Airbnb at night. I don't know when that'll be. It'll be at some point, and I'll, tweet about it and then, show up to do that. And hope that, oh, I forgot to put pegs on these. Didn't even notice. I didn't put things on this. Was, oh, 2-4. Okay. Sorry about that. Talking and I forgot to do a thing. But yeah, so that Thursday will just be like, let's see what's up. Let's make this happen. And then the goal is on Saturday, if I can, I will stream from my Airbnb Saturday night from 9 p.m. to 11 p.m. And I will be streaming, working on, I have a Lego set. It's a Ray's speeder speed bike, small little Lego set that is meant for like emergencies or if I don't have anything or travel because it shouldn't take much to travel with it. Board says always fun to watch the Build with Baer Road Show. Yeah, I mean I'm just gonna take this one webcam. I'm gonna take the stand that comes with it, and then I'll take my headphones, the this, and then we'll just go from there. And it should be all right. Should work out okay. I think you'll have fun with it. I'll have fun with it. All right, so this goes like this. And then goes like that. All right, there's more of our backpack done. Oh, now we can, whoa, there's a lot of pieces to this part. Okay, great. Oh, there's a locking. It's kind of cool. There's a locking mechanism in here, so that you can kind of put it on and lock it in place instead of just doing pegs, because it's going to be pretty heavy. So that's kind of cool. I was at the giant Gundam store recently, and I've since been thinking about getting into Gunpla. I've never done any model building. It seems kind of intimidating. Any points I can start? So, this is advice that I've given in the past, but will certainly work here as well. First and foremost, you want to try to work in high grade. High grade is a great starting spot. This is a master grade kit, right? I would say build a 1/100 high grade. The 1/100 high grade. It's a big kit, but it's not gonna have a lot of pieces. They're gonna be big pieces. Like a leg is gonna be like clip this into that with this rubber piece so you can plug the other thing in. Go slow with it. Like I said, high grade is a great place to start. Another great place to start with is a kit you know really well. This is a kit. I know what a Zaku kind of looks like. There's lots of extra pieces, but I've built Zaku. I've built, over the years. I know what they're supposed to look like. I have a good sense of it. The Death Scythe, which is my favorite Gundam. I know what the Death Scythe looks like. I don't have to think about what a Death Scythe's supposed to be, and that just makes it easier because you're like, you can do some like assumptions or intonation of like, okay, well, if this goes like this, then that works. The four grades that they exist are high grade. High grade is the simplest. Real grade is the 1/4 scale. It's like a high grade, but it's got some tiny little details that make it a little bit more like a master grade. This is the master grade scale. This is a big master grade, but that's what the master grade's like. And then there's perfect grade. There are non-grades. That's annoying, because you're like, this doesn't say anything. But I would say pick a high grade that looks like from a kit that you like, a Gunpla you are into, and then take your time with it. The biggest thing you can do to help yourself is, you can use wire cutters if you don't have snipper clips. You can use kitchen scissors if you got to. I have some cheats that when Dan Reckert, I went on a giant bomb for Extra Life, and he worked on his first kit. I just had him cut pieces out of a sheet, because the one place you can fuck up is cutting your pieces out wrong. So, like that's the thing where you do need to, take your time with it and find the right pieces and make sure you've got things together, because you don't want to snip through a piece. Good luck with it. Take your time with it. Don't live stream yourself doing it. It's really fun. One of the reasons, like, there's two reasons why I do this, right? One is not a lot of people do model kit building on stream, so that's fun. That's cool. I thought that would be fun than just playing games all the time. But the other reason why I do it is because it's a sense of accomplishment. At the end of the day, like, for folks that are here in the chat often, they saw this as just a bunch of sheets. And they saw the Zaku, the body get built, the head get built, the arms get built, the legs get built, the waist get built. I mean, we just built the waist yesterday. And we finished the legs and put it all together. And now we're like building this cool backpack that goes on here. And then we're gonna put a bunch of other cool shit on this backpack. And we accomplished something. I will put that out. So I hope that helps. I hope that's not too much. Yeah, get a high grade kit. I would say Bandai, like a Gundam is a good place to start. Because they've been doing it for decades, right? All this learned knowledge. A kit that you buy that is a 2018 kit or a 2016 kit is gonna have years and years of research and understanding and development in it. They've learned from countless things. There's gonna be a lot of stickers in high grade, because that's how they get away with detail. You know, they might do a solid piece, and maybe instead of having a little peg here that's gold on this, there'd be, like, on the shield, there'd be just a gold sticker. You know, that kind of thing. That might be there. The Grimgarde that we might do at some point, we will do at some point, we might do soon. The Grimgarde is a kit that I guess the 1-4-4 scale, the smaller scale, is has a lot of stickers. And a lot of details were missed on it, which is sometimes a shame. But I don't mind it too much. I don't mind a sticker here and there. I don't like applying them. You know that. Y'all know that. The fact that this next kit only has two stickers makes me kind of want to put them on. The Grimgarde. Also, it's fun to say Grimgarde. Grimgarde. It's a good-looking kit. But I also, we just built a red kit, so maybe I don't want to build another red kit. I don't know. As someone who started as a normal modeler with aircraft, tanks, etc., Bandai's engineering is some of the best I've ever seen, even high grade. Oh, I mean, like, one of the things that I remember hearing Dan said, and then I've also heard from other people who watched, you know, some of my earlier stream stuff that were just kind of watching because they know me from comedy or whatever, that don't really follow Gunpla stuff. The number one thing they said was like, oh, you don't need glue for any of this? Oh, that's cool. And I was like, yeah, it is. It's been very cool for a long time. But they think about building, yeah, like you said, aircrafts and tanks. And I built model cars when I was a kid. And I was never great at it. Even the die-cast metal stuff, I was never particularly skilled with it. I enjoyed it, but I was never good at it. But when Gundam Wing came out, I went out and bought a Death Scythe High Grade. I think the first one I bought was the Death Scythe Hell High Grade. Or it might have been the regular Death Scythe. I don't know which one it was, but it was a Death Scythe, of course, because that's my favorite kit. And I put it together with scissors, like kitchen scissors, and rocking pieces, like getting one snip in and rocking pieces out. I remember doing it on a very small workspace. And when I finished that first kit, oh, I was like, I have a Death Scythe, and I put it together, and the parts that I fucked up, I fucked up. And it just, I don't know. It felt like such an accomplishment. I felt like I was so proud of myself for that. It was obviously an incredibly easy kit to build, but I felt like, I don't know, I felt really great about the work I had done there. But yeah, please, if you end up buying, if you end up making a kit, send me photos. That goes for everybody. You know, you can always post them on our Discord. I put the link there. That's in the show description on YouTube. But I also, send me a tweet. I like when people tweet me photos of stuff they worked on. We're going to get into the time of year where people will hopefully start putting stuff together. That's model kits. That's Lego sets. That's, you know, like building. You know, you're working on a woodworking project. You're painting miniatures. I fucking love seeing that stuff. So please, please send that to me if it's something that you're working on, because I do really love seeing the work that people do. It's very cool. So hopefully y'all will send me some stuff. And I always retweet and throw a comment on there. Just, you know, as a little like, hey, thanks for sharing that. Because it is very cool. All right, so we got to do this. We did this. Then we're going to do exactly the same. We're just working on some things that go on the top of our backpack here. These are like the last steps of this, it looks like. So we'll just finish off what's left of this backpack here. Let's do exactly that one more time. So we need D3, D13. I've been low on creativity and productivity lately. It's a shame. Maybe if I have some money over around Christmas, I can get myself something. Yeah, Johnny, I mean, you know, you find it where you can, and you do the best you can with it. I will say doing that wrestling belt and kind of doing an original idea and kind of fucking it up, it could have turned out better as a kit, but overall I'm still very pleased with what I accomplished with it. It was nice to do something original. It felt pretty cool. I haven't shown that off. I'm waiting till the show to debut it. But I finished the placards for it, it turned out pretty good, I think. But yeah, that'll go out to folks. Folks will be able to watch that. As I said, I'm going to be in Philly. If you're coming to PAX Unplugged, I will be there. I will be hanging out in Bandland. There are no bands, but they still call that Friends of PAX hangout spot Bandland, for lack of a better term. That's what they call it. So I will be there, selling merchandise. We got some stuff. And then, of course, I have a panel on Sunday. The least amount of panels I've had at PAX in quite some time since League of Heels started. Because I usually have one of my own and League of Heels. I'm actually very pleased that I only have the one panel. Because running a booth and doing multiple panels is a lot. Especially at a show that I don't have. I mean, I have some good, fine folks helping us out, but it is good to just be focused on the one panel and then selling merchandise. And then also, skipping out to see things and seeing people and hoping they come by, checking stuff out. I am looking forward to that. So hopefully people will come by the old booth and see me, because that would be cool. I'm looking forward to having a bit of a. It's not a vacation because I am working, but it is a vacation from my day job instead, or my night job, and instead is working a different job. Doing retail a couple times a year doesn't hurt anything, especially being a small business owner, Aaron and myself, who is looking like we will see at East. Don't want to say he's definitely going to be there, and then turns out he isn't. But we think that that's going to happen. Has not officially opened the store. He has a location. He's moving in still, so it's kind of tough when you're the sole employee of a place to be like, oh, and then also I'm shutting down for a bunch of days. So it's going to be a little rough, but hopefully we can get him out. It's weird doing shows without him. It's his baby, so that's kind of strange. All right, so we're doing this stuff here. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. But yeah, if the Amazon gift cards come y'all's way, one, treat yourself, take care of yourselves, of course, but if you want to buy me something, I'll build it on the stream. And then, as always, if there's something you don't see on that list, you're like, oh, well, this thing's available through Amazon Prime, and you should build it. Like, always, please tell me about stuff, because I'll always consider it. Someone, I don't remember who, I wish I remembered. I'm so sorry that I don't remember who told me about the kit that I just bought. I'm gonna look it up. I'm gonna sneeze while I do. Pardon me. Pardon me. Harold says, "Let me know if you need an N64." I appreciate that, Harold. I think we'll be okay. If for some reason Aaron can't make it to PAX East, he's gonna have to ship me some stuff anyway, and so we'll have him ship me that N64. Let me see here. Oh, so I bought myself, using some money from this thing, from y'all, the Lego Nexo Knights Tech Wizard Showdown. I'm gonna put a link in the show description. I don't know anything about it. It was on sale and it looks pretty cool. And someone told me about the Nexo line, but it's just like a giant robot. And I was like, I want to build that. So I'll put it in chat here. I bought that. That's the thing that I'm going to be able to buy. And it seemed pretty cool. So I don't know. I was like, oh, that seems like a fun thing to have. I also just like, yeah, I like this year that I've built a lot of Lego stuff that isn't Star Wars. There's still a few Star Wars Lego sets I want to build, but it's fun that there are other stuff we can do that isn't that. All right, so I have a D15, D15. All right. And all right. Okay. So put that, then we need D4 and D2, D14 and D2, say. D2. Yeah, like I said, I'm looking forward to a lot of kits I have. I got a lot of stuff here that I'm looking forward to building. But I'm always looking for more, so feel free. Oops. I still have to buy my dad his Christmas gift. I bought my mom hers, but I have to get my dad his. I try to do it around this time of year, but it didn't work out this time. But it's not hard. He is very easy to shop for. He just tells me what he wants, and I get it. And this year, he just wants a Home Depot gift card. So that's very easy to do. It does not take a lot of energy or effort for me to get him a Home Depot gift card. So I can definitely do that. I can make that happen. So this goes in here. This goes like this. This is pretty neat. Opens up. Got some pinchers here. Closes up like that. And there's another thing that goes over it. Pretty neat how this all comes together. So we'll put these together here. Then this snaps into that. Have you built any Star Wars character kits or any zero? So I haven't done any character kits. I have done Poe's X-wing, and I've done the regular X-wing, the model kits for that, and I didn't love those because they are basically high grades until they're not, and there are a couple pieces that were just like really frustrating and some parts that I didn't necessarily enjoy that building part. So I haven't done the characters. I've also done a Rey at a Lego, which was a small-lived line. It was not that popular. But that was on sale when Toys R Us was like going out. I got one of those. I wouldn't mind in the future doing that, but it hasn't really come up. I think that they were up. I had them up on my wish list for like sometime last year. I put them up, and nobody bit, which is fine. But yeah, because I've done the Dragon Ball ones. I've done a few of them. I have a few on my wish list there, and I really enjoy that because it's fun. I still would like to build that Piccolo someday because that would just be cool. I might just end up getting that myself at some point if that's not a thing that people want me to build. But yeah, certain possibility. If they show up on Amazon again when I'm looking at Amazon stuff, I might I might go for that. All right. Touch in here. All right, we're gonna go for a little bit longer, and then I'll be back on Monday at 2 p.m. Eastern time. But yeah, we'll still build here for a little bit. We got a few more. I'm gonna try to get as much of this backpack done as I can. But there's still so much left to build. All right, so we need 12 and 13 here. Okay. 12 goes on this side. 13 goes on this side. All right. And that goes like this. And that snaps on here. These little things snap on this side there. And then something happens with them, and I don't know what happens there. I assume weapons go on the thing as well. Oh, I've missed a step. There's D10 goes on top. Is kind of cool. So it sits like this, and then it opens really far. Like, I assume this is like to help move weapons on and around, but it's a Gundam that has like arms like Outlaw Star. We talked about Outlaw Star a while back. It was a while back, we talked about that weeks ago. Well, yeah, I kind of like this robot has like weird mechanical arm attachments. It's pretty cool. All right, so we got to build that again. On the other side, 15 and 16. Then 12 and 13. All right, once I finish this up, we'll attach the parts we need. We'll put the backpack on, and then we will probably call it a show. And then on Wednesday, we'll do whatever's left. Just finish it up and then start on the next thing. By Wednesday, I will have done a poll. I'll probably put it up on Monday, and put like two things up that both came from my wish list for my patrons, my $10 a month patrons, to decide what I build next. And it'll either be the Grim Guard from Iron Blooded Orphans, or it will be the Ninjago Volcanic Lair. We haven't done that many play sets. We mostly do vehicles, or people, but we've only done a couple sets. So I looked at that and that looked cool, and then someone bought that on my wish list, which is rad. I don't know who. I wish I knew. I have to make a video of that kit, put it up on the internet. Probably put that up on Tuesday, I guess. So I have new stuff coming up all the time. All right. So let's try to figure this out here. Attach this backpack. That all right, and then we can lock it by pushing some pieces there. We lock it in place so it doesn't come off, and our backpack is on. So let's it does not want to stay up. We I have to eventually build the base. The base is gonna, we'll have to do on Wednesday. Because this thing is not going to want to stand up on its own. So I'm probably going to take that off, take the photos. But yeah, we got to build the base. And we got to build the rocket boosters. Which are the long things. We got to build this stuff that involves these pieces here. These are sheets we've never touched. We have not worked with P at all. So we got to build rocket boosters, put those on. You can attach all our guns to that, which is pretty cool. Our many, many guns have to get attached to that. And our rockets have to get attached. This is nonsense. It's wonderful nonsense. But yeah, we've still got a lot more to go here that we can build. I was a fool to think that we were almost done. But we did get some progress done today. Completed all our weapons. We completed our backpack, which now I'm going to take off, or figure out how to take off, so I can photograph it. But yeah, thanks so much for joining me today. I hope you had a good time. Thanks for everybody who new came by. Thanks for everybody who subscribed. As I said, we hit 30 subscribers, which is our new, which is, we hit 32 when I first started, like, at a big push, I think, actually, no, when Twitch Prime became, like, a thing, like, a big thing, it felt like we had a good push right there. But, thank you so much for that. That's awesome. Thanks for hanging out. I will, see you all on Monday for games and Wednesday for building. For now, thanks for hanging out. Thanks for being here in the Baer Cave, building model kit stuff, and, chatting and talking. And I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.